Hello everybody. I've got my different specs on and I can't see as well with them. So, hi Kevin, Greg, Mr. Greg, you're in early, yeah. Mr. Greg. There's no one quite like Mr. Greg. There's definitely a poem coming there, Mr. Greg. Hi, Paul, as usual. And hi, Rona, Phil. And hello there, Gary. What a fetching little teddy bear you've got waving to me there. Or is it Oscar? I don't know. Specs are pish. I think I look better in them, though. It's all vanity, you know. Anyway, I'll have a look at who else is there in a minute. Here's a Bob Dylan song. I heard it the other day. There was a movie on the telly. MM was watching it. It was Matt Damon had bought a zoo. And there was some great music played in it. I didn't watch the whole film because it was actually a bit cheesy, but you know, some nice bits. But anyway, this song featured in it, and I thought, oh God, I haven't heard that for years. It was on Blood on the Tracks album, and ironically, when that came out or thereabouts, I was sharing a flat with Blood above the fish shop in Cowdenbeath High Street, and he thought, oh, I've got to buy that album, Blood on the Tracks. But actually, it was the only Dylan album after Blonde on Blonde that I really rate. There's bits and pieces here and there I like, but really he did his best work when he's very young. But I liked Blood on the Tracks, I like a lot of stuff on it. And I like this one, Buckets of Rain. Buckets of rain, buckets of tears, got all them buckets coming out of my ears, buckets of moonbeams in my hands. You got all the love, honey, baby, I can't stand. I've been meek and hard like an oak, seen pretty people disappear like smoke, friends will arrive and disappear. You want me, honey, baby, I'll be here. Fingertips. I like the way that you move your hips. I like the cool way that you look at me. Everything about you's bringing me misery. But I like what I like the way you love me strong and slow. Taking you with me, honey, baby, when I go. Well, life is sad, life is a bust. All you can do is do what you must. Do what you must do, and you do it well. I do it for you, honey, baby, can't you tell? Well, buckets of rain, buckets of tears, got all of them buckets coming out of my ears, buckets of moonbeams in my hand. You got all the love, honey, baby, I can't stand. Buckets of rain. Hi Pete, hi Marianne, Hi, Derek. I'm going to try and swear, not swear as much this week, Marianne. Hi, Derek. Hi, Julia. Margaret. Marion. Jens. And hi, Teresa. Hang on. Hi, Eddie. I haven't seen Eddie Dixon for years. Well, once this lockdown business is over, Eddie, we'll meet up in Wee Jimmy's or something, eh? See if we recognise each other. Hi, Andrew, Tom, Neil, Paul. Yeah, Paul's referring to his Cognac Twins t-shirt, a very smart t-shirt. It's actually very good quality as well, because I've worn this a lot, and it hasn't fallen to bits, unlike many of my other garments, which are, as usual, cheap pish. Hi, Cyril. Hi, Gary. Young man. Do that for me every weekend. Really, it really cheers me up. And hi, Greg. I will mention you every time I see your name, Mr. Greg, because you're a very special person. And hi, Paul Sinclair, you wagstaff of the First Water. Okay, this is a... which is sort of a country song. Like a lot of these country songs, it was written by some guy who had never heard of, called Hugh Bodigo or something. I can't remember his name. There's lots of versions of it. My favourite one is Joan Osborne in Scotland singing at the Transatlantic Sessions. And she's got the wonderful Jerry Douglas playing lap steel from America, and the two guys that are always in Transatlantic Sessions, Ali Bain and Phil Cunningham, and various other people. Some geezer called Bruce Molsky, I don't know anything about. And I'm pretty sure it's Danny Thompson. It looks like Danny Thompson playing double bass in it. Anyway, it's absolutely superb. And it's a lovely bit of torch song. As you know, I'm kind of partial to torch songs. It's called Please Don't Tell Me How the Story Ends. And I need to capo it. Not having quite the same vocal register as Joan Osborne. This could be our last good night together. We may never pass this way again. Just let me enjoy it till it's over or forever. Please don't tell me how the story ends. See the way our shadows come together, softer than your fingers on my skin. Someday this may be all that we'll remember of each other. Please don't tell me how the story ends. Never just the echo of forever, lonesome as the love that might have been. Let me go on loving and believing till it's over. Please don't tell me how the story ends.
Please don't tell me.
Sniff, sniff. Very sad. Okie dokie. Quick look again. Hi Gail, glad you got through. Hi Leslie, Stevie, Steph. Hi Elizabeth and Eddie Hook, how you doing mate? Chip Shop, Cowdenbeath. High Street. Trying to remember, the chip shops that I frequented, Eddie, were Profili's, which was in the middle of the High Street, next door to Gronbach's the Butcher's. Can't remember a chip shop across from the Picture House. Maybe could have been one. There was a takeaway, Chinese, just a bit down the road, called the Yellow River. Quite a good name for a Chinese takeaway. And the Sun Hong, obviously. There was a great chipper up, halfway up Broad Street, called Zuni's. I've no idea why. One round on Moss Side Road. Davies Chip Shop, Dalbeath Crescent. But can't think of one opposite the Picture House. I'm glad you liked that, Teresa. Hi, Sue. Hi, Vanda. And hello, Frankie. And Doc Beman, how you doing, matey? Right. Funnily enough, I've just spotted your name, Jock. And the last time we were speaking about me doing my own songs, you said one of your favourites was Somewhere Else. This is not about a pub. I dedicated it, I think, to Alex Cole Hamilton the last time I did it, but it could equally as well be dedicated to Douglas Ross. They're both very good at making the positive case for the union. I'm sure you've heard of that. It consists of saying, Scotland is shite, your bridge is shite, you're all shite. You can't deny yourself, it's all shite. There we are, that's a positive case for the union. Only I kind of toned it down a wee bit, you know. Anyway, this is called Somewhere Else.
Stupid and too weak. Maybe there is somewhere else that you would rather be. Maybe there is somewhere else that you would rather be.
Apologies if I seemed a trifle testy in my introduction there. Is this leading up to elections, you know? Always a very, very tense time, you know. So, enough of this political carnage. James Taylor, something in the way she moves? Something in the way she moves looks my way or calls my name. It seems to leave this troubled world behind. And if I'm feeling down and blue, troubled by some foolish game, she always seems I feel fine anytime she's around me. She's around me now almost all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell she's been with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time. Yes, and I feel instrumental now. Haven't done this one for a while. This also is one that Jock frequently requests. Hi Neil Johnson and hi Craig. Hi Carol. I'm glad you're emoting, Jock. You need to emote more. Hi Cass, how you doing, mate? Right. Hi, Kathleen. Right. I'm going to carry on regardless. So this is one that Jock frequently requests. I'm not sure why. I think it's very near and dear to him. Can I get comfortable in this chair tonight? I don't know why. Anyway, this is called The Clap, and it's an instrumental originally done by Steve Howe of the group Yes. And it was called The Clap just because when he used to do it, because it's quite rhythmic, people used to clap along. Which was a big disappointment to me when I found that out. Played that for a wee while, so I need to keep playing it. Okay, thank you. Another quick look. Hi, Tom. Kevin, I think I've said hello already. But anyway, this is just another of my torch songs. It's a one by. It's on an album called Genius Loves Company. Ray Charles duets on it with various different people. And on this one, he duets with Bonnie Raitt. And it's, like I say, it's my idea of sonic heaven. Ray Charles singing and Bonnie Raitt playing slide. It's fantastic. Go do whatever cross your mind. Thank you. do I ever cross your mind? Darling, do you ever see some situation somewhere somehow triggers your memory? One more acoustic number. Old Faithful. As Jock is always saying, you should do more of your own numbers. He's probably right, but you know, I do this gig every week, you know, for people to enjoy it, but all to do because I enjoy it, and I love singing the, you know, these great songs that I hear other people doing, you know. And I also like doing my own stuff. Oh, which reminds me, I'm not going to do one next week. I'm going to have a week off. Not going anywhere. Still can't anyway. Just I'm starting to get to grips with some recording stuff and things, and I think if I have a week off doing this, it'll give me some space, because believe it or not, I actually prepare for this. Everyone's hee-hawing with mirth, but I do actually It's just because I don't want to keep doing the same songs all the time, so I'm always learning new stuff. Anyway, this is Broad Street, one of my favourite of my own songs, and that just is what it is. Checking guitarist plugged in. Empty bus goes rattling by. November rain on the pavements. No moon in the sky. Lonely souls in the evening, walking alone. In my memory. Midnight falls on Broad Street, taxis zipping by. Autumn frost on the gardens, winter in the sky. I'm here as a young man, walking alone. In my memory. Electric set now. One of the other reasons that I'm having a wee break next week is that I find myself coming back to the same things again and again, especially in this bit. It's just because, well, mainly because of I don't have the time to do, which what I prefer to do is not use anyone else's backing files, just make up backing files myself if I'm going to use them. And I really prefer to do that, but it's quite time consuming, especially the drums, because, you know, and even when you spend a lot of time in it, it's still not brilliant, but, you know, it's better than nothing. But, so this is some numbers that I've done probably in the last couple of months. I would like to branch out a bit. I wonder if I completely knocked out a tune there. That's okay. Not too bad anyway. Okay, so the first one, Rona often requests Santana, and other people do too, but mainly Rona, I think. And I learned this one because I wanted to stop doing the same ones over and over again. And I want to do it because I'll forget it if I don't keep doing it. So this is called Europa. Europa. I've actually got a longer version than that, but I find if I indulge myself too much, I start to just play a lot of old twaddle. I prefer to keep, unlike in my young days, I prefer to keep solos quite short. And I like improvising, I enjoy doing it, but there comes a point where you just wallop and away and everyone's falling asleep, you know. So, hey, anyway, this is another of Moan songs. Most of you that tune in will have heard it before. It goes right back. I wrote it either late 70s or early 80s, probably early 80s. Played it with two or three bands. And it's a kind of Thatcher's Britain song, you know. It's called The Good Old Summertime. Didn't take switch your eyes on for a while and saw the city's evil smile, breathe the poison air and walk across the street or around the block, hang around and watch the clock and listen to the worthless talk in the good old summertime. With your carpet in your hand, will you beg or turn to crime? In the good old summertime, in the good old summertime, destitution on your mind, can you hear the death bell chime? In the good old summertime. Artificial warmth, shops and pubs and restaurants, the service with a plastic smile can fool you for a little while, but in the end it's all the same. Go downtown, sign your name, and in the meantime try to find a way to fill up empty time. In the good old summertime, with your capel in your hand, will you beg or turn to grind? In the good old summertime, in the good old summertime, destitution on your mind, can you hear the death bell chime? In the good old summertime. One more number to do. Thank you very much, everyone, for tuning in. And remember, no gig next week, just to give me a wee bit of time out. If any of my younger listeners, like Jack or Amelie, are listening, this is usually the one that they like. I like it too, because I am a big bairn. It's called Werewolf of London, and it is one of these great songs. That is all from me, despite that half-hearted count in there. Okay, thanks very much, folks, for listening to me yet again. And I won't see you next week, but I will see you the week after. And then after that, we're into sort of semi-lockdown here in Scotland anyway. I'm not exactly sure of what it'll be like in the Republic of Ireland or even down south. Everything's slightly different everywhere, but we all seem to be, touch wood, heading in the right direction. So, see you all in a fortnight, and thank you again very, very much for tuning in. Good night.